The NRL has today reaffirmed its position on sin binning, despite last night's bizarre turn of events at Suncorp Stadium. The controversy completely overshadowing Queensland's 26-6 win in Origin 2. Adding to the Blues' dirty night, Paul Gallen and James Maloney are in doubt for next month's decider. Adam Hawes has the story.
The Blues are back, beaten and bruised. The skipper with another fight on his hands.
They sort of already ruled me out for 2 weeks, so that's obviously 3 weeks away, so I'll see how I go.
Like Origin 1, brawling has hogged the headlines.
Now some punching. Trent Merrin, now it's exploded.
Trent Merrin's attack on Brent Tate triggering the first test of the new crackdown on fighting. It ended with four in the sin bin and left plenty asking why.
I think Brent Tate's been charged with headbutting somebody's fist.
No one could quite believe what was going on.
I sort of wish I just had have unleashed punches because I would have got exactly the same penalty. You know, they're trying to clean up the game, but, you know, it's really making it a bit ridiculous, a bit of an embarrassment, really.
Mal Meninga calling for a vote from fans on what they want to see.
I find it a little bit, you know, silly the way the rules have gone.
I think they should just get back to the way footy was. It was the greatest game of all before this rule has come in, and now all of a sudden things like this are overshadowing the game.
That's just how it is now, and it's a schmozzle.
Pierce left with stitches after an elbow from Billy Slater that escaped a charge.
That's just how it is. If we do the same in game three, it's play on.
The bad blood bubbling. Merrin's one-match ban not placating the Queenslanders.
Do I think he deserved more than a week? Yes. For a king hit, you're only going to get a week now.
The drama taking the gloss from another Queensland triumph that has them eyeing a record eighth straight series win. The Blues left to lick their wounds and to consider changes if they're to end this maroon dynasty. Adam Hawes, 10 News.